fast sixes.
And I'd say Link's the best twisted fade in North America as well. So yeah. Being able to get that with the final pick is a bit of a steal. However,
yeah.
Really, really low. And as you can see, now that the lane is at level 7, Alltech is getting a little more aggressive. That lands, though, and it's a bit dangerous.
They stack the slows. What a soul shackle as well to shut down Doublelift from coming back in. There's the disengage, but do they have the re-engage?
Whoa.
Here comes Twisted Fate. They get the expunge, and they drop down Krepo. The turn goes on to Doublelift. Helios is very big right now, and what a turn in the counter. Aphromoo is forced to jump. Here comes the Mega Inferno. It shouldn't be enough. A sliver of health onto Aphromoo, but it's not over. The teleport comes in, and Seraph gets locked up on a few minions in the feet of Doublelift and can't reach the fight.
Wants to disrupt it.
Looks like we got to stop on Inox's teleport unless he did it.
Yeah, Seraph
he's going to be running down.
Polymorph.
Right. Very unfortunate for them.
Trying
they
to peel off the
dragon. Dexter takes a few hits that he does not want to now, seeing two CLG members with a combined 600 HP, and Seraph with the better of that. They're gonna have to move out of this one. It looks like EG may have just roamed across the map to get themselves a dragon.
Inox all the way down, now an EG dragon. So when all is said and done,
wow.
EG gets the upper hand here. CLG is also a team that historically has kind of given the dragons up four turrets, but right now did give Doublelift some time in the bottom lane, so not too much went wrong there. Oh man, they want this.
They've broken the black shield, the flash over, it goes to Helios. They're going to be getting a red buff refresh, but they do not get any kills. They do. He came back with a bit more pen and a bit of resistances on the side of CLG, so they cannot fight the damage that EG has right now at the 19-minute mark of the game. Another dragon over the Evil Geniuses, 2 of 2 here.
Where
versus CLG.
Fight come in though, no flash on Kog.
Looking for the cards. Oh, he gets
the cleanse.
It's the cleanse, but he walks right into a Lulu. You're not gonna be able to cleanse everything. You can only get so clean. Kathy and Surprise going down, but the team does not follow.
Riv, that's not the good fight back with the exact same actives, and then he outscaled them when he went to late game anyway.
Oh.
Not the case here.
Uh-oh.
They're going for him.
Uh-oh, Void Puppy, no! Oh, he gets it! The black shield
the
coming out! What a beautiful job by Evil Geniuses to bait that attack in. CLG going a little hard without the vision on the map, and it looks like they're going to be able to force this one back onto CLG. The pink ward goes down. They see Doublelift. They get the lockdown. They try to shut him down. Helios, he's just trying to walk wherever he thinks Doublelift would be. They're able to get the kill onto that one, and EG is just running rampant right now. Seraph tries to pick up something in mid lane, and even with
EG, Krepo with the timed gold card right there.
Oh no! Run, Pobelzer, run! Flash and Ghost! Keep going!
No. All right, CLG trying to fight back a little bit as well. Desperately trying to get kills, but this is not the way CLG wins. They're losing turrets, getting kills on the outside. Oh man, Dexter though, how many kills?
Another one goes in. Alltech, don't put yourself in a bad situation here. He does have double buff. It's going to be very nice for continuous living. Our
Inox beat him to the spot.
All right, Jack, here we go. CLG communication. Now they're making moves. Do they continue with this? Because look, across the map, they're getting kills, but mid-tier second is going down the mid lane. A huge wave.
Outer tier top turret for the just heart and soul of your base, the middle CLG, because they got the kill. But the importance of those turrets relative to the game means EG will win that one. And Doublelift, you're not getting back, buddy.
Oh, he dodges. Dodges one. Oh,
that'll tell him
Krepo,
where he is.
Good guy Krepo giving Helios the lock in for an assist and the rest of the team. Alltech picks up another kill, 4-1-0, getting a very scary Kog'Maw going.
Just take objectives on spawn.
And they have the timer to do it. And the position as well. They moved here well before the dragon was even going to be up. Counter-Logic Gaming is all in base, since they're not too worried about it. The Zhonya's is finally finished from Link. But do they have enough to close it out? Now that they're at the goal line, can they keep pushing on? They look very scattered right now, and they're gonna get dodged out on the Glacial Fissure. Alltech's in a great spot. Link from the backside gets a good Zhonya's, but I think he's got the focus of death, and he does go down to the hands of Pobelzer. This is kind of where it's scattered. CLG now sets up the lines, both teams
staring
into each other's eyes. Aphromoo goes down. No way, EG dances it out, and they get the lead on this one.
Riff, nobody died on EG right now. jump, double lift, and Serif trying to heal up desperately on base. They are on the Nexus turns.
What amazing games we've had today. For nothing to happen for so long, and then an instant, a catalyst to create the end of the game and victory for one team. This time, it's Evil Geniuses. 27-27 on the clock as they start battering down on the Nexus. And EG will take down Counter Logic Gaming.
This is the most excited I have ever seen EG after a regular season victory. Their rivals, who they could not beat in scrims, they just crushed in 27 minutes and 43 seconds.
What a definitive amount of gameplay. Dragon after dragon, not letting Counter Knock Logic Gaming even look at the direction of an objective, and continuously making off-the-ball plays that made CLG put their entire team in a section of the map and then lose a turret, lose another turret, and then even more of the domino effect came into play.
And if there was a game that EG had to win to turn their season around and potentially avoid relegation, it would be this one. We talked about how down you can get on yourself as a team when you lose week after week after week. And for EG to be the last place team in the LCS, to take down CLG, who was tied for first, as far as morale goes, and being able to practice and prepare for games tomorrow and for the next 2 weeks of the LCS, this is it. This could potentially reignite EG into a run.
What a just shock and awe matchup of back and forth. So competitive from Helios and Dexter.